Consider supporting me on Patreon to help me improve the videos and get access to exclusive models. Link is in the description. First of all, you will need to activate two add-ons. So to do this, you need to go to Edit, Preference, then go to Add-on and search for the Bool Tool add-on. Check this box and search the 3D Print Toolbox. When it's done, you check all the boxes and you can close this window and start modeling. I will show you three examples of non-manifold objects. I can press N and click to 3D print. And now if I click on solid, I see there is non-manifold edges. So when I go to edit mode and click on non-manifold edges, I can see that this face is not present. So if I press F, I create the face. And if I redo the solid step, I see that all the faces are connected and then this object is manifold. Now, if I click on it, I see there is four non-manifold edges, but no faces are missing. So if I click to non-manifold, I can see there that all the sides are not connected to this side. So if I pull this vertex, I can see that the mesh is deforming, but those two vertex should be connected one to each other. So if I press M, I can merge them by distance. And if I move this vertex, you can see that every face is moved with it. Now, if I go to this one, I see that three edges are non-manifold. But when I go and I click on this, I see that this side is not manifold. But if I go to wireframe mode, I see that there is a face inside of the model. So it leads to a non-manifold geometry. So to solve this problem, I just have to select this face and delete it. And if I redo the solid step, I can see that this object is solid. Therefore, it's manifold and every object is manifold. So here I show you how to clean up the topology by hand, but there is a tool inside of this 3D print toolbox that allows you to do it automatically. And it's called Make Manifold. And if I click on this on a non-manifold object, it will make it manifold automatically. Now I will show you how it applies to miniature creating. So I made this model, but you can see that it's composed of different objects. So for the legs, you can see there is multiple complicated objects. So now, to make it manifold, I need to join them. But I can't just press Ctrl-J and select everything. So for this, I will need to use the loop tool add-on that I enabled before. And by using this bool tool add-on, you will have new shortcuts for booleans. So if I press on those two objects and press Ctrl plus, you can see that they are joined. But before that, you need to apply all the modifier to all the objects you want to merge together. So to do this, you select everything, then go to Object, Convert to Mesh from Curve. It will take some time, and now that it's done, when I press and merge two objects together, they won't be affected by all the modifiers of the other one. Before doing all the boolean work, you need to make sure that all of those objects are solid. So as I showed you before, you just have to check for solid. So you can see, this object is not manifold. So I just have to press Make Manifold to make it manifold automatically. So I will do this for all of my cylinders that are non-manifold. And now that I select them and click on solid, I can see they are manifold. The thing about non-manifold object when you do some booleans is that you can't merge a manifold object and a non-manifold object together. It will always lead to a non-manifold object. Now that everything is solid, I can start all the boolean works and do Ctrl plus on all of my objects. Now that all my objects are merged together, you can see on the modifier stack that all of the booleans are present. So I will not just apply every boolean modifier at once, because if one is not manifold and makes a non-solid object, every other one will be false. So I will just apply every modifier one by one, and between each step I will check if it's solid. Here you can see that one of the Boolean work did not work properly and it resulted in a non-manifold geometry. So to correct this, you just have to press Make Manifold and continue all of your Boolean work. And now that is done, you can see that if I move the object, every object is linked together, and if I go to edit mode, if I press L, it will select all of the objects because they are merged together. You will have to do this for all the parts you want to merge together, and they will be ready to be sliced into your slicer and to be printed. Thanks for watching. You can get the model used in this video by supporting me on Patreon. The link is in the description. Don't forget to like and subscribe. It means a lot to me. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you next time.